When we think about private aviation, one of the questions we get is about the insurance side of this. And I know some competitors, like NetJets, for instance, is owned by Berkshire. So, you know, they get favorable terms in terms of, or you would think, in terms of the insurance. So one of the questions we get is, how much does that matter to us who are going to use your services? How do we need to think about the insurance? And what, when we say the insurance, you're not insuring me necessarily, you know, it's the insurance of the anything going wrong on the craft.
Certainly, yeah. So insurance becomes very complex in aviation. As it pertains to the aircraft, you have the hull insurance, you know, completely separate in what a passenger would not be concerned about. But any passenger should at least have an understanding of and be attuned with the insurance policy around their flying, because it is important. As a high net wealth individual, you know, safety is paramount, and we don't want things to go wrong. But God forbid they do, it's extremely important that everyone be protected. So insurance is generally covering the operations of the aircraft and the passengers on board. So traditionally, charter brokers may have a supplemental policy that is for any flight that they service, but incremental to that, any charter broker is also piggybacking on the operator's insurance policy. So for example, on our Dassault Falcon 7X, we have a $500 million policy for any passengers and any trip operations on that aircraft.
What would the individual from an insurance perspective need, if anything? I mean, is it as simple as you got us covered, we get on, or do, I mean, we talk a lot about travel insurance in my part of the world, but I think we're way past that. That's really more for the trip and
100%
default. And I do want to ask about supplier default.
Completely separate from a traditional trip insurance policy, right? Your trip insurance policy, from my understanding and experience, is that is covering your financial liability around your trip. This is entirely different in that it is insurance in case something goes wrong and somebody is injured on the aircraft. And it's as simple as like traditional bodily harm if somebody happens to slip on the plane, you know, to a larger accident that we'll, you know, not discuss because safety is paramount, and we make sure that things don't go wrong. And I can very happily say that over PJS's entire, you know, 20 years in existence, or nearly 20 years in existence, we've never had a safety incident, which we take very seriously. And part of the PJS open fleet and our proprietary fleet is that we have very stringent safety requirements where we're vetting other operators similar to our sister company of Elevate Jet, the minimum thresholds being, you know, Wyvern Wingman and Argus Platinum. Beyond that, as we on a day-to-day basis interact with different operators, we're maintaining notes on them. And, you know, we see, everybody can see FAA flagging safety incidents, but we go beyond that and are talking to passengers and other charter brokers to maintain our own proprietary list of, you know, operators that are operating at the highest standards from a safety perspective.
When you think about travel insurance, just because I can't help myself, it's a big topic with us. It's definitely trip cancellation. It's also supplier default, which is very important. You don't want to buy cruise line insurance because they can't insure against their own default. But its primary purpose is healthcare. So in the event that a client of ours was on one of your jets and had to do an emergency landing somewhere, out, if you were flying internationally, you would land and someone would get you, but you do have to have insurance for that. So I just always want to throw in a little plug for the insurance side.